Good morning. We are on Monday morning, June the 2nd. Welcome to June. And yeah, I didn't do a video yesterday. Did a lot of driving yesterday, so I was tired. We could get back to the show today. On a post. And it's my pleasure to share a devotional with you that might lead to a meditation. Alrighty, we are in 2 Kings. That is the 7th of the 12 books of the history of Israel. And we still got a story here about Elijah. So chapter 1, after King Ahab's death, the land of Moab rebelled against Israel. One day Israel's new king, Ahaziah, fell through the lattice work of an upper room at his palace in Samaria and was seriously injured. People still fall out of windows today, that's interesting. And fell through the window. Yeah, had a serious injury. So he sent messengers to the temple of Baal Zebub, the god of Ekron, to ask whether he would recover. He didn't go to Yahweh, he went to Baal. There's a point of meditation. Anyway, God tells Elijah to give him this message. A man came up to us and told us to go back to the king and give him this message. This is what the Lord says. Is there no God in Israel? Why are you sending men to Baal Zebub, the god of Ekron, to ask whether you will recover? Therefore, because you have done this, you will never leave the bed you are lying on. You will surely die. Okay. And a little further down. Then the king sent an army with 50 soldiers to arrest him. They found him sitting on top of a hill. The captain told him, "Man of God, the king has commanded you to come down with us." But Elijah replied to the captain, "If I am a man of God, let fire come down from heaven and destroy you and your 50 men." Then the fire from heaven fell and killed them all. It's not a good idea to give God the middle finger. And that's what these guys just did. So the king sent another captain with 50 men. The same thing happened. The captain commanded he come with them. And Elijah called down fire on them. They all burned. Now, this king isn't too smart, because he sends a third group. But the captain of the third group does have a little bit of common sense. Let's check it out. Okay. Once more, the king sent a third captain with 50 men. But this time, the captain went up the hill and fell to his knees before Elijah. He pleaded with him, "Oh man of God, please spare my life and the lives of these your 50 servants. See how the fire from heaven came down and destroyed the first two groups, but now please spare my life." Then the angel of the Lord said, "Who Elijah, go down with him and don't be afraid of him. So Elijah got up and went down with him to see the king. And the rest of the story is Elijah gave the king the same message and the king died. So, what do we take from this reading today? What is there to meditate on? Well, first of all, you can get your advice from the kings of this world, from the rulers of this world, or you can get your advice from the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Yahweh. It's all right here. All the advice you need. It ain't rocket science. Number two. Don't give God the finger. That just nothing good will come from that. How easy it is for people to snub God, because oftentimes the recompense isn't immediate. Yeah. And when it does come, the people don't realize it came from God. There's something to meditate on. Don't give God the middle finger. Don't get your advice from the rulers of this world. Get it from here. Amen. Amen. You all have a great day. God willing, we will see you tomorrow. And I will put a word of the day up. Bye for now.